flip the script. Have you guys personally known anybody that has done some
Fuck yeah. I know multiple killers.
Yeah, for real.
I know a guy that killed somebody, got off, actually got off, and killed somebody else. Fight Pat, man. Patrick Kelly.
Yeah.
From the township.
Yeah.
Killed a guy, got off, like beat the rap, and killed somebody else.
Right.
Wow. It's crazy. And he was the funniest kid in school,
man. Yeah, he was a fucking beatbox his ass off. He's always beatboxing his shit.
Yeah, we had a friend of ours.
He joined,
what's his name? Perry Holly.
Yeah, Perry Holly.
Oh my God,
he used to game with us. We used to game with us down in Alex's
office. He used to come to the office.
Hanging out, chilling at the office. He joined the Marines, did like 4 years, came
out. Straight fucking nerd, this kid.
He basically started working for armored car service, you know?
Okay.
So then he hatched a plan with his cousin to, like, rob the armored car, you know? And so, basically, he shot and killed the other driver. Yeah,
he just shot the dude.
But you're selling it.
And this guy...
on the route with this guy for a fucking year. His partner. Just them two. 8 hours a night driving around for a fucking year. You know, when me and you drive around, you know, that's all you do is talk. You get to know a motherfucker quick. You know what I'm saying? A year!
Right. So then shot him in cold blood. And the dude he shot had a family, everything, kids, all that. Opened up the back of the armored car. His cousin pulled up. They loaded all the money into his cousin's car. Boom, took off. Then he called, you know, 911. I got robbed. You know what I mean?
And of course, he forgot about the camera in the ATM.
There was an ATM camera across the street that caught everything. You know what I'm saying?
Fucking fool.
So he went to jail, and then his cousin ended up in
Red Roof Inn.
Red Roof Inn.
Yep.
He was in the Red Roof Inn. The cops tracked him down. He tracked his car down.
Yeah, he found out where he was. Ordered a pizza or some shit. And the pizza dude recognized him. So he bolted, and then the police were like, they came with another pizza.
It's so fresh.
But they just popped his ass. You know what I'm saying?
The cop came as a pizza man.
Yeah, but what happened?
So he opened the door, he fucking popped him. Like an hour later, it was live on the news. They sent a robot in there. He was already dead.
So when he answered the door, there was an exchange of gunfire. Like the cop pulled out his gun, and he went running for his gun or whatever.
He killed.
So the cop was like, pop, 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 just shot and ran down the hallway and took off. So they didn't even know they got him.
Right.
He wasn't even sure if he shot him or killed him or whatever. You know, because it was just one cop.
Robot boy in there.
And then it was like hours later, they finally went in there.
What did he think was going to happen? He was just hiding out in a hotel, right in the same city. All that shit happened there. Right. He was all over the news, wanted, manhunt.
Not only just hiding out of that hotel, but ordering pizza.
He didn't know it was all on camera, though. You know what I mean? He probably thought he was good.
Man, it was like 4 days later.
He was after Perry got pinched.
Right,
it was like 4 days later. Right, it was like 4 days later after Perry got...
Obviously, a criminal mastermind.
We knew Perry Holly. We knew him. We knew that.
I went to elementary school with that kid.
I played Dungeons and Dragons with him, Battletech. Like, we used to hang out with this ninja all the time. You know what I mean? Yeah. And I never would have thought he was capable of that.
Yeah.
But when he went into the Marines and came back,
he was
a little off. Like, I noticed that. Like, he wasn't the same. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So check this out, man, real quick. One of my boys I grew up with, he had an older brother, and he was in the heavy metal, whatever. So everybody was like, you know, thought he was a stoner, whatever. And he still lived in Saginaw. This dude ended up killing a girl, chopped her head off, and left her head in his house in a freezer for over a year.
Oh, shit.
And then his girlfriend at the time knew about it. And she didn't tell on, she didn't snitch on him
until
they got into it. And then that's when she went and called the cops. Cops went, and sure enough, man, in the freezer, there's this chick's head. Her body was underneath the house, I guess, or whatever, buried underneath the house. And to my knowledge, he's still in prison. I grew up best friends with this brother, man.
Right. Yeah.
So, I knew this dude since I was probably... 5 years old, you know what I'm saying? And I was like, no, that's not him.
Right.
And they were like, man, it's him. And I was like, are you shitting me? And then the same thing, like, I still stayed friends with the brother and his sister and his other brother, but they sort of just, you know, the family got shunned and everything, because who fucking keeps a head in a freezer.
That crazy might run in the family, man.
Yeah,
he's probably, taking it out.
Right, like, making out with it.
Shit, yeah, something is just nuts, though,
just
man.
Just chilling, I mean, watching TV with the head in his lap. Just, you know? Just
yeah, for you over a year.
That's fucking crazy. And when we lived in Ferndale and Hazel Park, the city right next door, same thing. These two burnout kids had a fucking head in the freezer. And they had some girls over. And they actually showed the girls.
Fucking right. Wow.
Like, yeah. What's wrong with people, man?
Right. Why would they trigger? Hey, let me
they're like, check it out, man. You want to see some crazy shit? They right. showed the girls the heads. And the girls still chilled with them all afternoon.
Right.
And then they left. And then the next day, they were like, let's tell the police, you know?
Yeah.
It's just so crazy that wow. they do that. Why would they fucking do all that?
Right. Exactly.